simple majority to do that in the United States Senate, and we can put everybody on the record. But, you know, right now parents are faced with a choice, and it really should be up to them. It should be up to parents and guardians about whether or not these little toddlers have to wear masks. It shouldn't be up to the Biden mask police. These mandates need to stop, and we need to put parents back in charge of their young people, and particularly when it comes to the issue of education, where these masks have proven to be a real deterrent to young kids being able to learn at school.
Well, Joe Biden is the president of high prices. Inflation will be a defining failure of this president's administration, to the point that in just 1 year as president, Joe Biden has driven inflation to a 40-year high. And at the same time, he's driven his own approval ratings down to a low of only 40% of Americans. And the reason we're seeing this is that people are paying the price and feeling the pain when they go to the grocery store, when they go to the gas pump. They're paying a dollar more a gallon now than they were when Joe Biden became president. Wages may be going up a little, but prices are going up much faster. So people can't keep up. Prices have gone up month after month after month since the president has been in office. People are feeling the squeeze. And who's getting hurt? Well, it's working families trying to get by. The average family in the United States has to spend $275 more dollars each and every month now just to stay even from where they were a year ago compared to what it would have cost last year. So people are going to have to change and are changing the way they drive, the way they shop, the way they live. People are having to tap into savings if they have savings. Inflation is crushing people's dreams. Energy prices are much higher to heat your home this year. Who's affected by that? Well, it's people trying to get by. It's people living on a fixed income, people struggling, young couples, all of them. And on the specific issue of inflation, the Harris-Harvard poll shows that only 3 in 10 Americans support what the president is doing on inflation. Only 3 in 10. That means that every Republican and just about every independent and a whole lot of Democrats don't agree or believe in what Joe Biden is doing on inflation. So what's the solution? Well, it's more government borrowing, more government spending. That's going to make inflation worse. When people look at this president, they see somebody who is out of touch and in way over his head. And unfortunately, the American people are paying for this president's incompetence.
Well, on the inflation front, the biggest driver of the inflation number, the 40-year high inflation number, is energy prices. And frankly, the energy prices are exactly reflecting what the administration and the majority in the Senate say they want to do. They want to raise traditional energy prices so high that people have to look for alternatives, and they've certainly managed to do that. You know, a 40% increase in gasoline at the gas pump, a 50% increase in a lot of home heating bills, 10% increase in energy across the board. And then some of my colleagues think the solution to that is to eliminate the federal gas tax that funds highway, road, and bridge construction. They must not have read the plan on their side, because the plan on their side very much reduces output, makes us more energy dependent on other countries, and is designed to raise energy prices. All you have to do is get your home heating bill or go to the gas station to find out just how successful they are.
The United States is one of the greatest producers of energy out there. And yet, under the Biden administration, he has made us ever increasingly dependent upon Russia and Iran for our oil sources. So the United States has increased its imports from Russia to 202,000 barrels a day from Russia. That's the highest it has been in 11 years. And again, we are one of the largest producers of energy right here in the United States. So why on earth are we ratcheting down on our energy independence and becoming increasingly reliant upon an autocratic thug, Vladimir Putin? And we see what he is doing to the Ukraine because of their dependence on other sources of energy. So let's ramp up our own energy production here in the United States. Let's uncouple from Vladimir Putin. Let's become an exporter of American energy once again. It's really important. Again, why are we relying on Russia for our energy needs? And while we're on the topic of Russia and Ukraine, what I would like to know from this administration is, how are we going to safeguard American citizens that reside in Ukraine? We have heard very little from the State Department, and it is their obligation to make sure that we are protecting our American citizens abroad. And yet we have heard nothing about a plan to evacuate Americans. I am very concerned that we are going to see Afghanistan 2.0. What we need from the State Department is more than a 1-800 number. We need a real plan, and we need to protect Americans abroad.
For years, the media parroted the Democrat narrative about Russia collusion. And now, as we're learning week after week, that is a complete lie. The latest with the Durham report is that the Clinton campaign, the same group that fear-mongered this Russian collusion, actually spied on the President of the United States. They spied on the President of the United States. They spied and they lied. We need accountability. We need accountability for the Clinton campaign. We need accountability for Adam Schiff and Jerry Nadler, because they were complicit in this. So the media needs to start doing their job, talk about exactly what's coming out, and hold these people accountable. On top of that, the Attorney General, Garland, he needs to be out there making sure that Durham has all the resources he has. He needs to do a thorough investigation.
Tuesday afternoon, do you think we're going to have government funding? Is there going to be an issue with these amendments or this proposal by Senator Lee on vaccine mandates? Senator Blackburn concerned about these so-called smoking kits and so on. Is this going to be worked out, or are we going to be here Friday night?
Yeah, this is often the case. We'll process a few amendments before doing the short-term CR. I think it'll all be worked out. There's no danger of a government shutdown.
You all have been railing about inflation for months, but just in a matter of minutes, Republicans in the banking community are trying to boycott this markup of all these Fed nominees. Is that a responsible way in dealing with inflation by scuttling these nominations from going forward?
Well, these are highly controversial nominees, extremely controversial, who repeatedly expressed the view that the Fed should be involved in things that are not the Fed's responsibility. The best way for this to stop is for the President to quit sending up these kinds of nominees. We have to have the most responsible people at the Fed now, not the least responsible. The Fed has got a big job ahead of it in trying to tackle inflation, and I think there's a lot of skepticism that many of these nominees are not up to the job.
Senator McConnell, can you talk about the impact on this economy, on this country, on Americans, if there were to be military conflict in terms of the cost of energy, in terms of trade, in terms of interest rates? What would be the repercussions?
It will be unfortunate for the whole world. I mean, you can't have a major conflict in Europe without having an adverse effect on all parts of the globe, which is why everything that could possibly be done to deter the Russians before an invasion is critically important.
Leader McConnell, do you think this upcoming election is critical in steering the Republican Party away from the former president?
Well, I think the next election is critical in sending the current administration a message about how it's been conducting the affairs of our government. Democratic president, Democratic House, Democratic Senate, look at the results. Look at the results. The American people are going to have an opportunity this fall to give a midterm report card on the performance of this all-Democratic government. We are optimistic that they'll want to push the pause button, want to give the Congress to the other party, and it, as I've said repeatedly, if they do that, we'll give the president finally an opportunity to keep his pledge to the American people to be a moderate.
But what about the